Welcome back to Boca Laguna, Mexico. We're here for the IWWF Water Ski World Championships, where it's time for the men's slalom final. Let's join Desbert Kennedy down on the dock.
World record holder Chris Parrish, he's cleared the 13 meter line, he's cleared the 12. This is the 11.25. Settling in now at the halfway point, a giant of a man, 6'5", 6'6". You can see that long reach, easy out around boy 5, over to 6 and out the end gate. Just what we would have expected from the guy known as the Tower. Coming back now in the 10.75. Beautiful gate, nice boy 1. First off the dock, all the pressure now on Chris to set a good score here. Needs to run this 10.75. Should be easy for him. Early. Pull over to 6 and a nice clean exit gate. That's the way. Now the pressure is on. Coming back on the sure 10.25. Personal best is on the 9.75. This should be easy peasy. Let's watch the setup. Chris Parrish through the gate, 10.25, and around ball 1. Oh, he looks like he's struggling a little on 1. He's very tight on 2, going down as he attempted to get around 2. You can see the look of mystery on his face. Oh, that's a huge shock. First off the dock, personal best on the 9.75, going down with a score of 1 on the 10.25. Now, Brando Caruso, Italy, two boys in the 10.25, that's his personal best. A nice clean 13 and 12, this is the 11.25. Really needs to run this now to set up. Oh, running into trouble. 3.5 on the 11.25. That is devastating for the young Italian. So again, looking at that 3.5 going down. Oh, you could see far too tight. That's the score. Big disappointment for this young man. Next out, Australia's own Joel Howley. Well, Joel is a personal best of 5 boys on the 10.25. Very strong contender. He's already cleared the 13, the 12, and the 11. This is the 10.75 line. Now, do we have a challenge to take the lead? He's got to run this entire pass to get beyond 1 on the next pass. That score of Chris Parrish, and that would give him the lead. Looking very strong as he comes down to the closing moments of 10.75. Yes, he's cleared it. We have a challenge for the lead position. Joel Howley has to get anything beyond 1 to take the lead. Pulling out wide, setting up nicely for the gate. Strong two-hand position all the way through. Snapping around ball 1. Looks good on 1. He's got 2. He's now in the lead. Oh, just a little short on 3 as he looks back. But we have a new leader. So from Australia now to the United States, Jonathan Travers, half point, the 9.75 is his personal best. This is his 12-meter pass. Should be easy, no, but it's not. Oh, we have a sensation. Jonathan Travers, a strong contender. Anybody with a personal best on the 9.75 has to have ambitions for the podium. But as we could see, devastation on the 12-meter line. Official score, 0-12. Next out, Freddie Winter, the sensation from Great Britain. He's got a personal best of 1 on the 9.75. Very strong contender. He has cleared all the passes up to this 10.75. Very powerful slalom skier. Just see how much energy he puts in. Very tight on each ball. Nice and early out to 5 and through the gates out to 6. Now the challenge is on. He's cleared the 10.75. Well, when your personal best is on the 9.75, you've got to have podium ambitions. This is the 10.25. Needs a good gate, and it's a perfect gate, and a round ball 1 heading towards 2. If he gets 2, he'll tie for the lead. Can he make to 3? No, he's just over the front. That slalom skiing taking off like a rocket, but having to settle for 2 boys on the 10.25. So from Slovakia, he's cleared all the passes all the way up to the 10.75. Strong contender, personal best is 3 on the 10.25, capable of running this. Very nice start at the halfway point, snapping around each ball. Nice tight line all the way through. Can he make it through and take on the challenge for a title lead? He's oh so close, but not close enough, having to settle for 5 on the 10.75. So, next out, Cale Burdick, the pharmacist from Michigan. He's cleared all the passes up to this 10.75. Well, he's got a personal best on the 10.25. He should run this, settling in very nicely at the halfway point early on 3. Oh, breaking at the waist. He's in serious trouble. I don't think he's going to run this one. Oh, he knows he's not. Oh, what a disappointment. Cale Burdick having to settle for 5 boys on the 10.75. Next on the water, Will Asher from Great Britain. So here he comes. Again, a personal best of two boys on the 9.75 line. A very strong contender, but somehow he's got to get better than two on the 10.25. This is his 10.75. Got to clear this, and he looks like he's making this oh so easy. Oh, that's the way to do it. When your personal best is on the 9.75, that's what you expect. Now, can he somehow take the lead and get beyond ball two on this 10.25? Here comes the challenge to get, possibly, onto the podium. Around ball one, looking good on one, gets a great ball one. He's looking too sharp on two. Oh, just couldn't pick up the momentum. You can see the frustration as he has to settle for 1.5 boys on the 10.25 line. Now we're down to the final four, and Adam Sedlmeyer chasing the overall title as well as trying to get onto the podium in slalom, coming in on the 11.25. Quite an extraordinary athlete. He desperately needs a good score in this slalom event to give himself a chance of being on the overall podium. And you could not have had a better start than that 11.25. We'll shorten onto the 10.7 now. That's 39 off. Can he possibly run this? But look at this. He looks so dialed in, absolutely in control. You can almost tell in his head he knows he's run this. Around ball six and out the end gate. Now the overall points are really clicking up here. He's going to come back on the 10.25. Audience really appreciating this overall athlete on the top end of this wonderful slalom event. 10.25. Let's see how he gets on. Around ball one, looking good on one. A bit back on the back of his ski. Oh, couldn't quite make it out to two. So having to settle for a score of one boy in the 10.25. Now he might look a little exasperated, but I can tell you folks, that is a big one in terms of overall points. Well done, Adam Sedlmeyer. Coming in now on the 11.25, the 5-time European champion, World Slalom champion 2007 and 2011, Thomas De Gasperi from Trento in Italy. This 11.25, it should be an easy pass for him. He knows he's got to get two or better on the 10.25 to get onto the podium. In the lead right now, Freddie Winter from Great Britain with that top score of two boys on the 10.25, and Thomas De Gasperi with a very nice 11.25 under his belt. Now, can he stand up all the way through on the 10.75? 39 off, snapping around ball one, way ahead in time, early on ball two, looking strong on three. Now he's at the halfway point, four under his belt as he sees five within his sights, back on the back of his ski, but he makes it out to six and out that end gate. Now the challenge is on. He's cleared the 10.75, coming back to try to take the lead. He's got to do better than two on this 10.25 if he wants to do that. Through the gates and around ball one. Here's the important ball two, settling for two, but because of his seeding, that will put him into the lead ahead of Freddie Winter. Well, you can almost hear the sigh of relief. There is one happy guy. He knows now he's going to be on the podium with Freddie Winter. Two places gone, one place remaining, but we have two athletes left on the dock, so we're just being a little premature right now. Next out, Jason McClintock from the famous McClintock family in Canada, coming in on that 11.25 line. Likewise, he knows he's got to run this and get all the way through 10.75 and onto that 10.25. Holds the Canadian record, four boys on the 10.25 line, and that's a beautiful opening pass. Now the challenge is on. We're down to the last two. Jason McClintock coming in now the 10.75. He's just got to run this. Setting up for ball one, looking fine on ball one, struggling a little as he gets out towards two. Oh, pulled right out of his position, right out over the front. You can see the frustration. He had the podium within view, but the power of the Mastercraft launching him into space. Thankfully, coming out of that safely, but that's a big disappointment for the big star from Canada, Jason McClintock. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we're down to the last athlete on the water, and this is special. He holds the world record of 2.5 boys on the 9.75. It is, of course, Nate Smith from Indianapolis, Indiana in the US of A. This year alone, he's won the US Open, the Pan Am Championships, the US Masters, the Moomba Masters, the Malibu Championships. This is a very, very special athlete in his prime. This is where every slalom skier in the world will be watching a genius perform on the 10-7-5 line. You can see how much time he has to spare. All the work done before he gets anywhere close to each of these boys. Just a joy to watch. What an incredible athlete. Totally on top of his game, making that 10-7-5 look oh so easy. Well, this is it. This is the battle for the title of world champion. And if he gets anything beyond ball two on this one, he takes the gold medal. Nate Smith pulling out, setting up for a good gate on the gold medal challenge. He's got one. Can he make it to two? He's got two. Is this the title of world champion? Yes, it is. Nate Smith, US of A, Indianapolis, Indiana. Wow, what an incredible performance.
With Nate Smith and Thomas DeGasperi secured in gold and silver places, the drama wasn't over yet. Brit Freddie Winter and Australian Joe Hurley were tied at two on the 10.25, so would ski off to break the tie. Well, Joel at first beat his earlier score of 2.5 boys on the 10.25 line. Freddie responded confidently with three boys on the 10.25 to take the bronze.
It's been awesome. Yeah, I came here in 2009 for my first major tournament. It was the Under 21 Worlds, and I didn't make finals. I skied horrible, had no, you know, terrible memories of here, but coming back down here, the whole week has been amazing. The site's amazing, had a great time. It's memorable for sure.
Well, don't go anywhere. We'll be back with the jump finals right after this.